It's men's slalom final time now here at Sunset Lakes, Lake County, Florida, as we join Matt Crowhurst for the final 12 athletes.
It is time for the men to do their thing here in the slalom final of this World Water Ski Championships. Once again, conditions staying perfect. Beautiful here. It does not get any better than that, as you come to expect from the home of water skiing here in Florida. And it is Dane Meckler on the water right now, powering through 11.25 and looking very comfortable as well. So the difference between the women and the men is that the boat speed goes up to 58 kph or 36 miles an hour. So a couple of miles an hour faster is what the men are dealing with. The line length system stays exactly the same. So as you have seen with the women going from 11.25 now into 10.75, Dane getting a lot of slack out of each turn, getting later and later. He made it into the 10.25 rounds in the preliminary round, and he's going to do it again as long as all of the adjudicators, the officials, deem that he got round every boy cleanly, in through the gates, out through the gates. None of these guys at this level want to be missing the entry or exit gates. It would be criminal to get through their pass and find out they are out on a minor technicality. So we're into 10.25. Dane hooking hard round boy number two, standing up quite a lot, making him really late. Look at that. Oh, that is where things get a little bit fast and loose. He was so late that all he could do was throw his ski with all his might out as wide as possible to get the boy around. See how he throws it? Now, I am not sure whether the judge is going to see whether he got that boy around. Let's have another look. No, I think that went inside. Cracking on now. Skier number two. Look at that beautiful pass. We have got Jonathan Travers, yes, Travers of the namesake of this very ski school. So, a good skiing background for this young chap as he works his way through this pass at 11.25, looking smooth as you like. Hopefully not being the commentator's kiss of death, I keep saying that just to cover my back as he gets round. Boy number six makes it out those exit gates at, once again, this faster speed than we see for the ladies, 36 miles an hour. You see him pulling out wide, dropping in, cutting the line length to the next line length, which is 10.75. Making it through the entry gates. Dealing with the slack. Now just look for these. Oh, that was almost not going to be my fault. Before he even gets into the meat of that 10.75, Jonathan Travers not having a good run at all. That is going to be around 1.25 boys at 10.75. So an early finish for him. That is a shame indeed. On home turf as well. It is the job of young Rob Hazelwood of the UK, of Great Britain, coming in at 10.75. Boy number one, right before skier, so those boys 1, 3, 5, the offside turn. 2, 4, 6 should be the good side turn. Should be, if they do get late, where he can hook that ski a little harder. Not needing to at this line length, it doesn't look like from Rob. Looking fairly clean, fairly relaxed as he comes out of that. A big old woo as he gets through the gates. Just to suck it up and lower the tempo a little bit. We see Jonathan Travers there just getting some commiserations on the shore after him not having the best time of it, but I'm sure he will get stuck into enjoying the rest of the skiing in this world-class act lineup that we've got in this finals of the 2021 World Championships here at the Jack Travers Ski School. Rob Hazelwood getting spat out round boy number two. You can see the disgust in himself right there. A few expletives, I'm sure, but no less support from the crew on the shore. The Union Jack getting waved strong. I'm sure we'll see that Union Jack getting flown high once again as Will Asher takes to the water. So he doesn't get wide enough. The boy actually rides right, the ski rides right over the top of the boy, skipping him out. See him clip the boy there. So it wouldn't have counted anyway, even if he was able to ski round that and move on through the rest of the course. So utter dismay there for the young Rob Hazelwood. He will live to fight another day. Plenty of years left in that career. And from Great Britain to Canada we go. Stephen Neveu out on the water at 11.25. So just a couple of line lengths away from Sirius Deep Big, world record almost scores. Nate Smith, a world record holder, we'll be seeing him later on in this finals lineup. And Stephen making it look very easy indeed, as you'd come to expect. I keep saying that sort of thing at this level, but we can't ignore the fact that you have got the cream of the crop, the best in the business, lined up in this finals. Now, Stephen Deveaux coming in at 10.75 now. Standing up a little bit there out of boy number two, getting late into three. Can he make up some time? He is making it hard for himself at this line length. Can he make it round the final boy? That is all six and the exit boys. And that was not made easy at the early juncture in that pass. Stephen managing to make up for it and eventually making it look smooth as that line gets chopped, making it more difficult still. 10.25, here we go, two. Lot of slack out of that turn, losing him ground, as we saw, trying to get back to the next gate, boys. Yes, he does. So that should be three at 10.25. Now, what looked like a hopeless course as he was way out wide, see this, comes out wide to get the slack to then cut in hard to make it through to those yellow gate boys. In order for the buoy to count, as you get round it, you have to get back to behind the boats before those next set of gate boys, which Stephen did expertly, and he was happy about it. It is Greece on the water now with Philippos Kyprios coming in, 11.25. Slightly more different stance for this guy, slightly more different form, a little bit more hunched over the front of the ski with his upper body, but it doesn't seem to be affecting badly at all. So you see different styles throughout all the skiing, like you do in all sports, but it just goes to show there is no one size fits all. Every style can count. Sometimes a slightly more effective technique will win out as the norm, but here we're seeing it working just as well. Slightly more hunched position coming into the turns for Philippos as he enters 10.75. Now, can he keep it together? Oh, a little bit of lace standing up a lot out of that turn. He's round boy number four, somehow managing to claw back a little bit of time, a little bit of space. So he ends up coming into boy number six with time to spare. Yes, a bit of slack, but clawing his way back out of that little wobble halfway through that pass. 10.75 done, 10.25 coming up. We saw Stephen get through a few boys, three boys for him. What is Philippos coming up with? Oh, he's all over the tail, standing right up on the back of the ski. Nowhere near able to keep on his edge and get to boy number two. A little bit of frustration with thinking that we're seeing on Philippos, but still good skiing up until that point, doing Greece proud. Next gear on the water, the 24-year-old from the Dominican Republic, Robert Pagosi, coming in on this next pass, which is 11.25. Now, we've seen each of the skiers so far get through this lineup. It is going to have to be a number of boys at least 10.25, probably 9.75, that is going to take away a podium spot, never mind the actual title. But 11.25 looking good there for Robert. Now, as we're getting more familiar, those of us who are joining water skiing for the first time here, watching this world, and what a way to get introduced to this incredible sport, just start to look at the forces through which our skiers are putting themselves. 10.75, the forces get way, way more intense as the line gets shorter. Remembering that the boat speed stays the same, but as they slingshot left and right, they will be getting faster and faster and faster, getting through more slack, trying to have to resist more pull as they get that little bit of slack out of the turn. And this is looking good. 10.75 going to be almost 10.25 for Robert Pagosi of the Dominican Republic. We heard the cheers from the shore as they were elated for him to get it through that, because even if they're not supporting, even if they're not from this guy's country, even if they're not supporting him directly, they know it's going to make for a much more intense competition with the skiers left to follow. Here we go, 10.25, two boys. Oh, almost a little bit of trick skiing as Robert pulls a full 180 out of that turn. That was full on, just showing you how hard they are pushing it. They are skiing on a knife edge between that ski gripping the water and just getting spat right out as it did round there. Okay, boy one, a lot of slack right there, but just about managing to hold his form, getting good ankle. Watch this. He went so hard on that hook trying to get the ski round. He hooked it in to almost a full 360. Hopefully he's okay out of that, because the forces through which he was going right there were pretty intense. Now, the USA, Brian Detrick on the water, 11.25 for him. Can he do the same as Robert we saw before and the previous skiers to get through this, to make this competition even more intense than it already is? Obviously, the skiers left on the dock right now would hope that he doesn't. All of the crowd hope that he does. All of us watching hope that he does as well, and that's exactly what unfolds. 10.25, done.
come see Lake County.
Welcome back. We're here at the Visit Lake County Water Ski World Championships at the stunning Sunset Lakes in Florida.
Comfortable boy one. Relatively comfortable boy two. Looking like he's standing up a little bit, but then clawing back some form right there. Now he's got into the groove. It's looking smooth each turn. Even if they get slack, if they can just hold their form and just wait, not stand up, as he does, gets to the exit gate with time to spare. That is beautifully done. Now can he be knocking on the door of what he came up with last time? Three boys to match his preliminary round, his qualifying score. It's going to be needing to get deeper into this run if he's going to find a place on the podium with the caliber of the skiers left to follow. Boy one looking good. Two also, oh, standing up a lot. He's going to try and claw that boy three. Somehow manages to make it with a little bit of time to spare. I think he even surprised himself that he got there. And as he came out of it thinking, well, maybe I can do more, it wasn't to be. So that is boys three at 10-2-5. Here we have another bit of legendary status in the world of skiing. Will Asher has been there, done that within the skiing world. And I'm going to claim this right here and now. I even beat him at a slalom competition once when I was a wee nipper. That's my claim to fame right now as I comment on this guy from Great Britain making his way through the course. And Will will move on. There we have Team GB on the shore supporting Will exactly as they did for Rob, exactly as they will do for Freddie Winter, still left to come, exactly as all of the representatives from the country will be doing for each of their skiers on the water. The team affair is a big, big thing in water skiing. Okay, here goes Will. Oh, a little bit deep over that left shoulder around boy number one, but it's what the ski is doing that is the most important thing. And that ski kept its angle, kept its momentum, did not stand up. You notice getting that acceleration out of speed, what Will does well, look at this turn, actually manages to keep the ski down. When you ski, the nose of the ski pop up in the air, that's when the ski is slowing down, that's when they lose ground, or water rather, that's when they get late to the next boy, that's when it all starts to come undone. Here we go. 10-2-5 for Will Asher. He has been through this line length before. He has been on top of pretty much every podium out there. Can he do it again? That's two boys going for boy number three. He gets round. Oh, we're seeing an absolute replica as we saw from Stephen DeVere. And I'm not sure that was a scream of victory right there from Will. He is frustrated at himself. He knows he's got more in him. And what that means as Will makes his way back to the dock past the GB fan club, as he waves and acknowledges them, which is exactly the right thing to do. They're there supporting all the Brits right the way through. That we have three skiers on three boys at 10-2-5. Brian Dietrich, Stephen DeVere, and Will Asher, who you just saw there. Can this next skier mix things up a little bit? We have another Brit. It is Freddie Winter, another Brit who has also taken a top title right here. He has been world champion before. Can he do it again? It is 11-2-5. 10-7-5 and 10-2-5 before he can get to that top spot with what has been so far. Looking smooth so far. An absolute powerhouse in the form of Freddie Winter. He is, and that's how you get away with that kind of smooth skiing right through the 11-2-5 line there. Okay, straight back into things. Here comes 10-7-5. Remembering that distance between the boat gaze at right angles from boat to turn buoy, is 12 meters, so the line length, the handle, is shorter than the distance it takes for him to get his ski round. You can see that as we look down the lake on those odd shots right there, that the handle is not reaching the buoy. So to make these turns as they're doing is mind-bending. And such strength, such athleticism, such skill, and so many hours on the water for these skiers, like any top spot, to get to the stage. Here we go, Freddie Winter, 10-2-5. Boy one getting a little bit late. Boy two, oh, it's going to be super late into three. Oh, is it going to be three boys? Oh my gosh! And yet another skier tied at three boys at 10-2-5. And yet another skier frustrated. That guy there, along with the other skiers that have seen before us, do have more in them. But what they always have in them is a wave for the crowd, for the fans, including Team GB on the shore. An amazing skier, Freddie Winter, there. He will not be as happy as could be with himself. But that's all she wrote for him. He just gets to sit back and relax and watch the rest of the skiers to follow. And that next skier after Freddie Winter is Adam Suttermeyer from Czechoslovakia, coming in for his next pass. He will have already got a couple of passes under his belt until this point. It is 11-2-5 for him, where we are joining all of our Open Men's finalists. Big turn out of two. Punching that hand forward to the boys. He came in 2-3. Watch how different skiers do different things with the handle. Some of them turning that handle in, some of them keeping that upright, a little bit of a mix-up on side to side from Adam right there. Now his score in the first round, his qualifying round that got him here is that enigma, the three boys on 10-2-5. Can he get past that in this final? If he does, he'll be pushing himself into podium positions. We're on 10-7-5 now. He's got to get through this to even have a hope of that podium. Oh, a big slam dunk and super late. Round boy number four makes it up round boy number five somehow, and crazy late round boy number six, but still making it back to the gates in a fairly cool, calm, collected way despite a little bit of aggression needed to get through that 10-7-5. Here we go, 10-2-5. Are we going to get our skiers round the black hole that is that three-boy and into a boy number four? Let's see right now. How does he do round boy number one? Oh, there's a big old dip and a death lean out of boy number one. Getting a wheelie out of two. Huge wheelie out of three and not able to get to number four. And I guess the frustration is just increasing with skier upon skier that can't seem to break the mold around that boy number three. Or rather, boy number three is always in the bag, and it's the elusive boy number four that needs to be wrestled with. Can our next two skiers do that? We have got two left. Italy and the USA yet to taste the water, and it is Italy's Thomas De Gasperi, or T-Gas, as he's also known, to take to the water first out of these two. 11-2-5. You guys know the drill. He would have got a line length under his belt to warm up. Now coming in full swing to 11-2-5, which doesn't seem to have been much of a problem for most of our skiers at this point. And the same applies here for Tomas. Not only handy on the water, on his swerve stick, but also handy on the dance floor, I have just been told, starring the equivalent of Dancing with the Stars in Italy, would you believe? Kind of cool, but the focus right now is dancing on the water in the form of slalom skiing. He's made it round three. Can he get to four? Yes, he has. We are on 10-7-5. We're going to get to the elusive 10-2-5. Are we surely? Are we? Yes, we are. Making it around that boy number six. Beautifully done. And now we take on the one that has been the stumbling block, the 10-2-5. Either of these two skiers left, Tomas, or Nate Smith, going to get into that 9-7-5. Let's see. Come on, we want a boy number four out of this for Tomas. We've got one. He is late already. Two, super late, standing up a ton. Three, there it is. Oh, it's not going to be a four. Is it going to be three? Yes, getting through those gates. And there we go again, just racking up the consistency in this finals. Boy number three is where it stops on the scoreboard for Thomas De Gasperi, as with the skiers we've seen before. And there we have it. All skiers done but one. And it's only fitting that our current world record holder is about to take to the water next. Our current world record holder from the US of A, in the US of A, in the home of water skiing, Nate Smith, taking on 10-7-5. Can he make it look smooth as ever, as only Nate Smith can? So far, it is looking very much that way. Please don't let me be doing my usual and curse the skier out of the water as I say how good they're looking. Keep it going, Nate Smith. There you go. 10-7-5, smooth as like a breeze, a walk in the park for us mere mortals. Now for Nate Smith, it has been 6 years since he last took top spot at this very event. Did not go to plan in 2019, taking sixth spot. Can he right those wrongs right here and now? Beautiful boy one, manages to grab hold of it, can turn, standing up a little bit, but here comes boy three. Can we get past that benchmark? Yes, we can, and he can do it nice and early into four. Early into five, here comes six. Can he get the gauge? Yes, he can. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, you are now looking at the current brand new world champion in the form of Nate Smith. It has been 6 years since he's taken that title, and how sweet it must feel to do it on home turf. We are 9-7-5. This just for the fun, just for the glory, just for the crowd. One boy, two boys, it's a little up tap. He says hello to the boat crew. Let's go with the handle. Gives the crowd a cheer and basks in the glory of the knowledge that he's just taken that title down in front of a home crowd on home turf. Nate Smith, congratulations on becoming the 2021 world champion.
Amazing skiing by Nate Smith. Super consistent once again. Italian Thomas De Gasperi second, and Brit Will Asher in third.
The gold medalist and the world champion is Nate Smith. Thank you.
guys stacked up at that 3 at 10-2-5. So leaving the dock, I knew that it was game on. I had to kind of turn or die there at that 3 ball, and had a start I was looking for and got over to 3, turned it, and that was it. The lake's amazing. The weather's been absolutely perfect. There's a little bit of wind you feel coming across the lake. You can feel it more than you see it, but it's been a fun event to get to catch up with everybody that's been here, see, you know, friends that I haven't seen for a couple years, and then go out and compete with everybody. It's been a lot of fun.
Congratulations on a great event.
Thank you very much.
That rounds up our coverage of the slalom. Join us next time, where we'll bring you the final jump highlights.